science develops every day, there's always a chance that new developments will bring new ideas for war. And because chemistry is developing and techniques is developing, I think it's an issue of today, and it stays always an issue of today. I studied chemistry in Groningen, and I started as a teacher of chemistry in 1976. And at this school, where we are at the moment, I was there as a teacher till 2009.
Hey!
Hey.
What's it? And I like this work very much, because as a teacher of chemistry, I could get youngsters aware of society and responsibility of scientists. It was important for me that I not only gave lessons in chemistry, but also a little bit in history and ethics.
Poor Bernard.
Ma chère collègue.
Mon cher collègue. Ça va?
Ça va bien.
Johnny boy. Toen ben je daar gevallen?
Dat gaat me vallen. Ik bedoel, dat gaat me vallen. Deze meneer is ook de eerste crossover docent van Nederland. Want we hadden in de jaren 80 allemaal maatschappijvakken. En natuurkunde, scheikunde is natuurlijk heel erg beta, heel erg fout. Maar deze beta docent werd eigenlijk een maatschappijdocent.
Ik voelde mij ook een docent van een mensen-maatschappijvak.
Ja, was hij ook.
Ja, het is een combinatie van wetenschap, techniek en mensenmaatschappij. Dat moet eigenlijk altijd wel een beetje tegelijkertijd gebeuren. Ja.
En voor jou was ook ethiek altijd een heel belangrijk punt, hè? Zoals met dat toneelstuk toen.
Scientists, I'd say it's a rare breed. They can do great things. If you look at from a chemistry point of view, on a molecular or atomic level, it's no difference at all creating a chemical weapon or a fertilizer. I used to have classes from Chrétien Schouteten till 2001. He is one of the most amazing personalities one can encounter in high school.
Resultaten van experimenten. En de stofexposies werden hier gedaan, geloof ik.
Deze tafel.
Aan deze tafel, ja.
En dat ik met dit, dat we al die verschillende poeders gingen uitproberen op de stofexplosie universiteit. Nou, completer, koffiemolenpoeder. Dat knalde gewoon het hardst. Ja.
I asked him if it was okay if I could do some research at dust explosions. And he said, that sounds excellent. Not like, yeah, why not? No, that's an excellent idea.
Yes, I made many fires in the classroom. But symbolically spoken, yes.
He knows how to deal with people in that certain age.
What important is, I think, is to touch the pupils by trying to give them some idea about the experiences of the victims of the chemical war.
His trick was taking the examples.
Telling a story is very strong. When you give attention about the human factor in the story. as a teacher, I got interested in Fritz Haber, the chemist in Berlin who introduced chemical weapons on a large scale in Ypres in 1915. And I was always very interested in him because in him there are so many aspects of science, the good science and the bad science, and he had in his private life such a dramatic experiences.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
It is 100 years ago that this laboratory was opened. The first director of this institute was Fritz Haber. Fritz Haber started in 1911 and the First World War started in 1914. We will remember him as the man who could make ammonia from two elements, the nitrogen and hydrogen, and that's very important for feeding the world. From the ammoniac they make fertilizers, so he is a brilliant genius but also a tragic human being because of the context of the history. He was a Jew in a country which was against Jews and a dictatorial country. And he was also a patriot, so he tried to help his country and had no borders. That's perhaps the dark side of his life.
We discussed this in the chemistry classes, what you would do. There is a world war going on. Terrible things are happening. Are you allowed to use your knowledge to build such a weapon? I think it is a duty of a scientist to remain within this certain frame that you are contributing to a more prosperous world. If you don't have a strong bond with your ethics, there is of course an easy switch.
We've been tasked by the United Nations to perform this investigation of alleged use. They suspected also a chemical attack because some of the troops that were in positions downwind from the rocket attacks, around about 30 minutes after the attack, began to present some unusual symptoms. All of the affected personnel have been removed to a hospital in Karatavuk City, and we have 72 hours to complete the entire investigation.
Teachers have such a power if they realize, if they take their opportunities.
It is extremely confronting when you are like 17 years old. What would you do? And that's how he brought us these work ethics.
The pupils got their own opportunity to express their feelings or their thoughts. Some of them wrote poems, others made pictures or photographs or whatever. They had a creative expression after these lessons. You must start with a small fire, a small experiment with people to make a fire together and giving fire to more people.
Hi, everyone.
Ja.
Dat is toch iets symbolisch, hè? Oh, dat kan ik niet heel goed zien.
Hey, the Players of Theater 89. Katrin.
Guten Tag. Ik kan die namen immer nog niet uitspreken.
Chrétien.
Chrétien. Researched Fritz Haber's life and I wrote a theater play about his life.
We waren gerade auf der Suche nach dem Stein.
Ja, ich weiß.
The place is very special because we are at the spot where Haber lived.
Here he worked and he just had to walk 50 meters and he was at his work. And he lived here with Clara, but Clara shot herself in this garden and they made this monument for her.
His wife was also a chemist and she was strongly against this adaptation of the chemistry. And she committed suicide.
That she shot herself. The quarrel was in the house. Haber went to sleep. Herman was there, also sleeping. And she went outside and shot herself here somewhere.
Die schrecklichen Folgen meines Giftgases ersetzen die bereits bekannten und unvorstellbaren Gräuel nicht. Sie ergänzen sie.
War der Einsatz Ihres Giftgases erlaubt?
Er verstieß gegen internationale Vereinbarungen.
Das ist ein Missverständnis, Clara.
Ha, du hast recht. Oh, was bist du auch wieder haarspalterisch. Du hast in Ypern also eine neue Art Kriegsinvalider geschaffen.
In jedem Krieg sorgen Waffen welcher Art auch immer für Leiden. Das ist unvermeidlich.
Berlin, 1. Mai 1915.
Wie war Ihr Experiment aufgebaut? Wir haben uns für den festgefahrenen Krieg in Flandern entschieden. In Ypern haben wir, ohne dass der Feind etwas davon gemerkt hat, in unseren Schützengräben über eine Breite von 6 Kilometern 6000 Zylinder eingegraben. Keine geringe Leistung. Als der Wind endlich günstig stand, habe ich den Startschuss gegeben, woraufhin alle Zylinder aufgedreht wurden. Das Chlorgas strömte als grün-gelbe Wolke von 6 Kilometern Breite und 1,5 Metern Höhe über den Boden in Richtung des Feindes.
Und dann? Was ereignete sich dann?
Was wir gehofft und auch erwartet hatten. Die Franzosen und Algerier wurden komplett überrascht. Es entstand große Panik. Ohne nennenswerten Widerstand konnten wir das Niemandsland überqueren und die feindlichen Schützengräben erreichen.
Was fanden Sie dort vor?
Ungeschützte Soldaten. Nach Luft ringend, würgend und brechend, blutspuckend, sterbend.
Chlorgas wirkt sich nun einmal sehr auf die Augen, Nase und Kehle aus. Das führt zu höllischen Schmerzen in der Brust, Schwindelgefühlen. Die Lungen verbrennen, die Lungenbläschen füllen sich mit Feuchtigkeit. Letztendlich ertrinkt man in seinem eigenen Schleim.
One alpha checking the radio system or
when one state party alleges that chemical weapons have been used against it by another state party or a state not signed to the OPCW or by non-state actors, for example terrorists. You have to get out on the ground, you have to find the weapon system that was used to deliver the chemicals to the target, and you have to try and identify the chemical that was used in the attack. Still states that aren't joined with the OPCW, so that means potentially chemical weapons could still be out there. that are not controlled by any kinds of arms control treaty. And then, of course, there's the non-state problem. Some of these chemical weapons are actually surprisingly easy to make for a terrorist.
We have to be very aware of these dangers, and we have to face it and to check it, I think. It's not over. If everyone can make one person aware of the problem, the whole world is aware of the problem.